Uganda has a population of about 35 million. 78% are below the age of 30. Many of these youth, including graduates, are not economically engaged. This is attributed largely to the inappropriate skills young people receive from institutions of learning that do not match the needs of the labor market. Every year, 400,000 fresh graduates enter the job market, but many do not have the required competencies to get jobs. This challenge is being addressed by the United Nations Development Programme, working with United Nations volunteers and in partnership with the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development by helping graduates gain skills and experience through training and placement as volunteers in host institutions for 12 months.
I've been trying to apply for jobs, but with the difficulty. Many jobs need skills and experience, but when we've just graduated, then they need experience of 2 years, 3 years, which I do not have.
The Uganda Graduate Volunteer Scheme was launched in December 2018 with the recruitment, training, and placement of the pioneer group of 98 volunteers.
We believe that this approach using volunteerism will enable the youth to become employable and to be able to get better jobs in the economy we have in front of us.
The volunteers underwent orientation training to acquire knowledge and soft skills to prepare them for the workplace. Areas covered in the training included teamwork, work ethics, professionalism, report writing, financial literacy, career planning and development.
Personally, I'm a marketer. I did marketing at school. So from this program, I'm hoping to acquire better marketing skills, better public relations, teamwork, team building, coordination, organization skills, and so many more.
Many volunteers realized that a gap existed between their academic qualifications and the demands of their new assignments, and therefore welcomed the valuable experience they acquired during their placement.
I have experience to do professional communication, write and send out emails, write proposals, do media work like here in the studio. I can do production, serious production, because I've been learning for the last 11 months.
I've acquired troubleshooting skills. I have acquired a lot of software installation skills. And then I have also acquired systems administration skills. I also have acquired some soft skills like professionalism, in a way that, you know, when you're supposed to do something in a certain way and you're not doing it the right way, that is not being professional. So I have learned to do things the right way.
My community mobilization skills have also grown. My communication skills, because I do a lot of work with various stakeholders, right from the local government at all levels, district, all the way to sub-county, to village level. So yeah, I can say I've grown a lot.
Despite being new entrants in their assignments, many of the volunteers made significant contributions to their host organizations.
We came at a time when the national development planning process was beginning. So we've been able to support the development of the third national development plan. And specifically, I've been attached to the Department of Manpower Planning and Development, which is responsible for developing the country's first national human resource plan. So we've provided a lot of technical support in producing the first national human resource plan.
At UNDP, what I do is more of assisting the chief executive director. So when I came in, he had to offload some of his duties, like follow up on timesheets, check, update the files, whose contract is ending, who needs to be informed about the soon expiring contract, the terms of renewing. There were a lot of issues.
In some host organizations, the impressive performance of the volunteers earned them full-time employment, which is proof that potential only needs opportunity to emerge.
Hawa has been an excellent intern with us. I am actually very grateful that UNDP has such an interesting and very useful program that allows young people to access work or space of work to learn, but also to contribute in the place of work. I'm glad to announce that she has almost exceeded our expectations. We hope that we can maintain her even after the program, but it's important that also we give others an opportunity.
AFSA has been helpful to me a lot because most of my projects I've been trying to work with her directly. Actually, indeed, AFSA is a resource, so we at least extended our contract a bit up to December, but we intend to give a permanent contract next year.
Encouragingly, some volunteers are opting for self-employment, confident that they have what it takes to succeed.
As an individual, I think from what I have learned, most likely I may not get out to again look for a job, but get the skill from the skills I've learned, I want to open up maybe a consultancy company and recruit a few individuals, and we shall be able to do consultancy, especially pertaining research and policy issues.
Some volunteers put their knowledge in financial literacy into practice and were able to use savings from their stipends wisely.
I was able to finance my education. I completed my postgrad in project planning and management, and this is all thanks to UGVS. And also, I was able to start up my piggery project in Lira.
These testimonies make a strong case for more young people to be supported to access workspace experiences for enhanced employability.
As a country, I think we need a national policy on graduate volunteership. This has been only a drop in an ocean. How do we support the education system to relate what education produces to what industry is demanding? That lies in preparing volunteers from the education system to transit to the world of work.